think we should do this, maybe.
Yeah, okay, cool.
And this.
And then that.
Or do you think we should do this?
And then we can flip, yep, we can flip them around. And then keep, I think that's a good beginning, though.
Okay.
And then that should stay there.
And this is more impactful to end this way?
That's more, yep, way more impactful to end it that way.
Okay.
I think that's a good way to do it.
Okay, good.
Wonderful.
Welcome to the Washburn Weekly Webcast.
At the Minnesota Science Teachers Association Conference 2 years ago, I found the co-founder of the program, We Share Solar, and then I approached her. They have a program for We Share Solar in partnership with Minneapolis Public Schools.
What kind of changes did your project did?
Okay, so since the project is about energy and is about electrical energy, so my students were able to use their concept of electricity and electrical power to build a solar system that can then convert solar energy into electrical energy and make it in such a way that it is compact enough to travel. So when we started the project, all we knew was we wanted to build a solar suitcase in line with the specification that Wishare Solar gave us. We knew that it was going to go somewhere in the world where this would be needed. We knew that it was going to go somewhere in Africa.
It was interesting, an interesting project.
Challenges in getting the project done. Understanding the concept of energy and power, because I also needed to all build it into the physics content that my students were learning, and they were ELL students. So working and at least understanding the concept, working through our syllabus, doing this project, was a little challenging for them. But one thing I liked about them and all the time we were doing the project was their commitment to finishing up this project.
Challenge for me for the solar project, it was probably connecting everything together and making it work. I haven't seen it yet in action, but I just know it works. I've tested it here, so.
For me, it was gratifying. It was also humbling in the sense that I, Angelo Suji, with my students here in Minnesota, made some contribution to something that went from Minnesota to my home continent and went to also serve students. So my students are helping designing solutions for fellow students. What more could I ask for?
It feels great helping out people who are trying to get their education done.
Is this a project I would like to do again?
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, if it isn't Ari Kimball and Kiara Brown, last year's Poetry Out Loud finalists.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, Lauren.
How's it going?
It's pretty good. I was just sitting here wondering if there's anything going on during fifth and sixth period today.
Is there anything going on? That's right! It's the 2023 Washburn Poetry Out Loud competition!
Oh my goodness! That's so exciting!
I know, it is such a big deal.
I can't wait to hear the results.
Make sure to tune in to the live stream. Make sure to support your peers.
And stay tuned for the results.
Hi, I'm Sophie.
Hi, I'm Emma.
And welcome to Magnificent Miller.
Let's see who won this week.
Natalie Richardson-Wymore, grade 12, nominated by Mr. Jim Schmidt, or Feldschmidt, for professionalism, integrity, and determination. Natalie goes above and beyond in her efforts and is quick to offer her kindness to others.
Great job.
No, what?
Who's staff of the week?
What?
Tell me!
Guys, it's time for staff of the week.
Oh, dang, staff of the week!
We're gonna go surprise them.
Okay,
you go surprise them!
Yes, Natalie!
What? Cassidy!
Rhea, staff of the week. Wait, Miss Rhea Oceana.
Wait a minute.
Who's the staff of the week?
Both of you.
I'll
hold the credit card.
Oh, yeah.
I think that's fair.
Someone's going to hold that first. Who gets the parking spot? That's a good question.
Should we rock, paper, scissors,
butter?
Yeah.
Okay, ready?
Rock, paper,
scissors,
shoot.
Oh, we're equal. Grace, I have to think alike.
I know, I know.
Okay, so now here's the big question. What's your favorite art medium to work
with?
Ooh, I'm
going to
say charcoal.
Ooh. Always going to have to be ceramics for me.
My New Year's resolution is to find the bumper sticker that someone stole off of my car.
To finish all my college applications.
To get me a boyfriend and start my fashion business.
To not get a D on Mr. Cummings' test.
Not getting mad when Chipotle don't give me my chips.
To get through a math test without crying.
Get good grades.
Get less good grades.
Be happy. I want to get another cat. Yeah.
To get my money up.
Make more money gambling.
To not spend all my money in one day when I get paid.
I want to be more stretchable.
I don't have a good answer. Y'all are making me nervous.